What? Guys, I just loaded in this zone. There was nothing here. Okay. We're fighting an ice troll. Alright. Aloth is in front, unfortunately. Completely unprepared for this. I mean, ice trolls aren't that tough, but... Alright. So, last episode... We, fought the Gleaming Society. And yeah, that took us the entire episode, because we died and then reloaded. Hey. Can we knock it down? Someone knock it down? Well, at least he's getting his hits in. Aloth, that is. Oh, that thing came back. Regenerated? Okay, cool. Oh, Kana got up to 3 already. That was quick. Oh, we just got to have to, deal with a slightly damaged Aloth. That was interesting. Anyway.
Slowly now.
I don't know how that happened, but, got a little river reed over there. That's the waterfall we were talking about, so that cave down there maybe is where this person's twin, soul twin is, hanging out. You read that? Cave behind a waterfall. Doop! There we go. There's an obvious bridge here, but let's just go see what's up here, if anything. Nothing much. What is this, too? There's another waterfall, isn't it? Water trickles down glistening pillars and spears of ice. A few rocks peek out from between them. Peek! Hey, rocks. Being all cute over there? Peeking? Yeah, let's not have Aloth be in front. Especially because of things like that.
Following your lead.
Hit that. Oh my god, there's a lot. And there's Lagufath and Lagufath Broodmother. Okay. Okay. Switch weapons. And by that, I mean not your bare fists. Let's see if we can possibly... I don't think these things can be knocked down, so we'll save that for the others. Holy Radiance. Let's do a Soul Ignition on this one. Maybe we can kill it. Piercing Burst. I guess that's it for now. Oh my. Heal. And... Heal. Still casting that? I guess she cast it now, okay. Oh, she's out! Oh my god! Pelagina's dying at a rapid rate lately. Let's go blessing. I killed it. Awesome. Wade into battle. Who's this? Oh, Palagina. Well, she can't fight that. Take down that thing. Oh! My god! Our priest is down. I did not notice that. Kill this. Oh god. Don't cast your spell. You don't have to run that close, do you? Alright. Knock that down. Knock it the hell down.
Yes.
Alright, take another one. What can I tell you? Okay, you hit that. Chain lightning. You knock down this one. Or not. I didn't realize he was so damaged. Okay, run back. Knock this down again.
Hey.
Okay. Get your skeletons in. Yeah, you might as well hit it.
We gotta take better care of our allies.
Better care of our allies, yeah.
Okay.
I don't think the swiping thing works on it. I am drinking that thing like water. Oh, Kana's got a knockdown.
Eh?
Oh, she just fell. Okay, it's just the two of us. My god, these battles are getting tough. Make sure we are hitting.
Hey.
Oh my god, Kana. Oh wow, good. The skeletons are gone already? Bring more. That, pal. Oh my god. Insane. Insane. Yeah, and what? I wanted to play on hard difficulty. You heard me.
If it makes you rest easier.
Not yet, it won't. First, we need a rest. My god.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Yeah. Gonna save, because We don't know when our next battle is going to be our last. Alright. Anything at the end here? Nope. Okay. I'm gonna keep sneaking in case something's just over there. Almost done with this map though. I'm gonna... You know what? That goes down to the cave. I'm gonna check up north first. So what we're gonna do... Well, actually, this is the end of the map. Let's just go up here. Oh, campfire. Trap detected.
And the fire shows me something new. What? A simple test.
I hope so.
A simple test.
Nothing else to be found here. Alright, let's, everybody except for...
I'll do the prodding around here, Walter.
Yes, you will. That's a new one. Because I've selected everyone but him. Alright.
I can do that.
You ready for this, Durrance?
A simple test.
Well, it didn't hurt him that much. Oh. Another camping supply, good. Been going through them rather quickly. It's good to say.
No problem.
Slowly now.
Oh, there's a path going up that way. See, I did go back to town. Midway through... Oh, I thought that one was alive. Midway through last episode, but I didn't talk to, what's his name? I can't remember these people's names. Well, I guess it's a task. Teeldor. I didn't talk to Teeldor, so... Still have that to look forward to. Okay. I try to walk all over in case there's something hidden that we need to go near. I wonder if we're gonna find these Sisterhood of Steel or whatever. Greater Ice Blades. Looks they might have you know what with them, Lagofath thingies. Everybody.
Following your lead.
I deselected him. Well, there's a Wraith. A Wraith? Have we fought a Wraith before? Wow. I hope they don't drain levels. Pretty big battle. I got three specters, a wraith, two greater ice blights, and a Shenwilla. Shengula? I don't know how to say that. As strong as this wraith. Let's cast Disintegrate on it. No, she's stunned. Never mind. It's always her. Is just everyone else resisting but her, or is it targeting whoever the main character is for whatever reason? I'm not sure if we can knock those things down, probably not, but I'll try once. He's attacking, right? Okay. Chain lightning. Alright, start with the healing. Well, he didn't get to use it. It died. Alright. Oh, he's stunned. That too. She didn't get to use her spell. Disintegrate on the Shenguilla thing. Thing then. Oh my god, the priest is... What the hell, man? What are they hitting us with? Spectre hit Durance for 8 freeze damage. Greater Ice Blight hit Durance for 41 crush damage. Spectre hit Durance for 5 freeze damage. God. Plus he was damaged from that trap. Yeah. Bring back Durance. I guess she cast her spell. Who is this? Oh, Aeloth? Aeloth hit it. Yeah, with this. We can't knock them down. Just finish off the Ice Blight. Heal it there. Everybody, hit it! We're kinda messed up here. Here. Kill it so we can continue. Thank you. Oh yeah, just run forward, Aeloth. Great idea. Heal. You can't get around that? Oh, never mind. Hear that ringing? Ooh, Excalibur! Let's grab all this crap. Spirit residue.
Got it.
I feel like none of us should be by ourselves over there with that crap, whatever that is. Just in case. Got one more.
See what lies this
way. Let me just look over here. And the spooky sounds here. You trace fading outline and shapes in these panels. It looks like there were once a sequence of reliefs, but the images have worn away. These panels have been worn smooth. In one, you can just detect the shape of a sword, and in another, the stocky body of a dwarf. And we got Excalibur. Behind a frigid curtain of water is an alcove, its walls flecked with ice. In the middle, you see a rough stone pedestal, also glazed with ice from the falls. A cruciform hilt and a tapered blade protrude from the pedestal. Judging from the size of the hilt and the apparent length of the blade, you infer that it is an estoc. As usual, we will be thorough and examine the area first. The alcove and the stone pedestal are little more than dilapidated ruins. Ice pries cracks in the stone and coats the slick floor. It's an awkward sentence. The estoc, what little of it you can see, appears to be in better condition. It seems odd that anyone would leave it here. However, as you get close to it, you hear what sound like the screams and shouts of tormented souls. And we got that with our good perception score. Relatively speaking, I suppose. Move in to pull the weapon from the stone. Is this a good idea? It's probably a soul-bound weapon, whatever they call them. Who will go? Tell Kana to grab it. He's used estocs for a long time, so he's a strong guy too. Tell him to grab it. Kana crosses under the falls, gasping beneath the cold water. Shivering breaths echo in the small chamber. Patterns of falling water flicker across the blade as Kana approaches it. Kana grips the hilt. The hate, fear, and violence of a dozen mad, gibbering voices fills Kana's mind. Kana shudders through a wave of mental pain, struggling to hold the voices back. Grunts and cries of agony ring through the tiny space. Keep holding on. Sorry, Kana, if you die now. Kana maintains a tight grip on the sword, arms shaking with effort. Eventually, Kana regains a measure of focus through the clamoring voices. Yet just as Kana's breathing steadies and the cacophony subsides, something pulls Kana's arms forward. It suddenly looks as if Kana is holding a heavy and painful burden. Kana could probably pull the estoc free, but it will be taxing without careful effort. Is it a good thing to delay at this point? Let's inspect the blade. The blade is of a fine, sturdy steel. Peering closer, Kana sees part of a poem written across the blade. 'Tis a traitor's fate to sleep and never rest, whilst knowledge of his deed stays lodged within his breast. But earnest penance heals the sorrowful man, and worthy actions stay the executioner's hand. Okay. Let us brace against the pedestal to pull the estoc out. I'm not sure if we're using Kana's intellect here. I mean, it would make sense, or if it's just our own. Fan of flames. We're gonna burn it out with Fan of Flames. Yeah, let's brace against the pedestal. Kana climbs on top of the pedestal and adopts a wide stance for better leverage. Draw the estoc from the stone. After working at the estoc, Kana is able to pull it free without too much difficulty. Oh my god. Yet when Kana tries to release the weapon, it remains stuck in Kana's fingers. Something within the weapon grasps at Kana's soul, binding to it. Some kind of writing glows from the blade. Oh boy. Cursed weapon? The Gray Sleeper. Find a whirling agent of copper, adra, and stone. I found an estoc in a mysterious stone pedestal near Longwatch Falls. Upon removing it, I realize that the weapon is cursed and soulbound. I should say Kana, not me. It tethers itself to the wielder. Okay, so there's that poem. The other verses may hold the key to removing the curse. Interesting. A new verse appeared after the blade was drawn. It reads, "Seek the whirling agent made of copper, adra, stone. Awaken first your essence so that you may atone." Whirling agent? some kind of, what do you call it? Animat? Wind animat or something? I think this is the first step in removing the curse.
Huh.
Well, Kana, what you get yourself into this time?
Following your lead.
The Gray Sleeper. This S-Doc has a smooth, sturdy blade that tapers to a needle-sharp point. The groans of a dozen tortured souls ring from the metal, binding the weapon to the hand of its wielder for so long as the curse persists. Here's the new verse. It is a soul-bound weapon. But what about Aloth's soul-bound weapon? That's not stuck to him. Can that be unequipped? 19 to 28 pierce versus deflection. 5 damage reduction bypass. This is a fine weapon, so it's plus 4 accuracy, plus 15 damage. I notice we don't have an option to enchant the thing or anything. 10% chance to cast paralyze on hit or critical hit. Why don't you just say hit? Because a critical hit is a hit. Funny if you try to remove it and he says something. You're like, I can't remove it. What about Aloth? He can remove his weapon. This is a soul-bound weapon. I guess this is a bad soul-bound weapon. That was awesome. I like that.
Quickly and quietly.
That's actually a really good depiction of a cursed item. I like it. I look forward to finding out how we get this curse off. I guess we're heading down now. You're right there, Kana? Where's the weapon he did have? Wow, we're really full. Oh, this crap should be in... Major regeneration. Got stuff in regular inventory. That's why. I must have forgot to hit shift or something. Empty spaces here. There you go. I should just switch places there. 2, 5. One extra. Okay. So I wanted to compare against what Tidefall is what he was using. Hold up. It's so cursed, it's like overbearing with its what do you call it? Its little stat paper here, or whatever you call it. Slow. Wow. It's not as damaging as what he has. That sucks. Maybe it will improve. That's all I can say. Yeah, I mean, the paralyze. Doesn't even paralyze for that long. 10% though, that's pretty good. I mean, you hit somebody 10 times, you might paralyze somebody. That's pretty good. If we can remove the thing, I probably will remove it to see the, to use Tidefall again.
I'll see what I can find.
Something's going on with the music there. Under the waterfall. Well, that's it. The last place to explore is this cave. Dwarven ruins, yeah, that's where we found that. Alright. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. Tune back next time when we enter, I presume, will be called Long Watch Falls Cave. Endure, and enduring, grow strong.